going to be my first eight-rounder, so we had to step it up a little more on the conditioning. In the training camp, we basically sit down more on our punches, you know, that way when we land, we'll be able to hurt them. My daily routine is, you know, waking up early morning, going to run, and after that, heading home, getting a protein shake, whatever, and after that, you know, head straight to the gym, you know, from like 9 to 12, sparring, whatever it is, mids. And then afternoon, sometimes I do strength and conditioning every other day. Since I was 5 years old, I grew up in the old famous Eddie Boxing Club. Once I started hitting high school, you know, I started just hanging with the wrong crowd, you know, I got into a gang. I started going to juvenile hall, county. I ended up in prison 4 years. And then I was out for 7 years. I took a fight with Golden Boy 48-hour notice. And I beat the guy, you know, Kirk Bills. Ever since then, Golden Boy kept an eye on me, especially Robert Diaz, you know, a special thanks for him. I know he's a strong fighter, you know. I know he comes out there to win, you know. I know he throws a lot of punches. I know he's only been knocked out once. And I know he's beat a couple undefeated fighters, even from Golden Boy. So I'm going to do what I got to do to win, and I know I come out with him. I'm excited, you know. It's my first co-main event fight. I'm willing to come out with the win no matter what.
That's our co-feature tonight, Ivan Delgado, Alejandro Ochoa, Beth Durant, Doug Fisher, Holly Lawson from the sold-out Belasco Theater. So far, there's been three fights tonight, three knockouts. I don't know if there's going to be a knockout on this one, but it's definitely going to be a battle, Doug.
I think this fight is going to give us rounds. Delgado's nickname is a striker because he does strike. He's got heavy hands, but he doesn't have that one-punch knockout power. And I think Ochoa, being the proud fighter he is, he wants to show people that the guy who got knocked out in one round by Chipe Gonzalez, that wasn't the real Alejandro Ochoa.
He scored a couple of upsets as well, though, correct?
Oh, Ochoa, absolutely. Yeah. Ochoa, last year, he fought a young man from the East Coast named, what was his name? Kevin Rivers Jr., who was undefeated as a pro and was an amateur standout. Very talented. Actually, viewed as a more talented prospect than Chipe Gonzalez. And Ochoa dropped him twice and outpointed him, and that was a huge upset.
So we're looking at a competitive fight here.
Especially if it gets warmed up. And not just a competitive fight, it can be a very entertaining fight, perhaps the fight of the night.
I do like Delgado. I've actually seen a couple of his fights. He's not flashy, not anything crazy one way or the other, but he's solid and he comes forward and he's got big heart. And I mean, I've watched a couple of fights. He takes his time when he needs to.
He does.
He's patient. You got to respect that. He has like pretty good fundamentals, and he kind of knows what he's about, and he does that really well.
It's kind of a unique style. It's versatile. I sort of liken it just to a natural fighting style. It's not like your average prospect who just has 10 pro bouts where they still kind of box like an amateur. He's
right.
Definitely more settled in there. He takes his time. He doesn't waste punches.
No. And he knows what he's good at, and he throws with bad intention, but he's not wild with them.
No, not at all.
Yeah.
A lot of the Golden Boy boxers make their way to the Belasco Theater. Christian Chipe Gonzalez, 20-year-old. He'll be fighting November 2nd at the Belasco. Get your tickets. He's a co-feature. Oscar De La Hoya, he might make it that night. Hopefully he can get a ticket to be here. of course, has a great time here at the Belasco. Christian Chipe, who's actually been running Mount Baldy, and decided to go earlier this week than normal because of the heat, and he ran into a bear. So
get out of here.
No, because it's been hot this week, so he went earlier, like around 5 o'clock, saw a bear, and like, oh no, that's a Snapchat. And here he is, snapping back the head of Ochoa in the second round stoppage. Boom.
And I can't state it enough that this was not expected. This was a fight, actually, when Gonzalez's management took the fight, matchmakers from other promotional companies called him up and said, what are you doing? This guy's a spoiler. Your guy's not ready for Ochoa yet. You're making a huge mistake.
You know what that says, though? That says your team believes in you.
Absolutely.
And they know what you're capable of.
Absolutely.
You got to really like that.
Yeah. Keep sending those tweets using the hashtag RingTVLive. For those of you that I just got a tweet right now. Yes, we would love to be at your house for carne asada. no, we can't go there because we are working, and I know by the time we get there, it's going to be gone, like a typical Friday night. You know, forget boxing and chill. How about carne asada and some boxeo? And there you see Alex Ochoa coming into the ring, ready to go from now listed as Santa Ana. And Ochoa, Doug, as you've taught me about him, he's that gatekeeper, but he's just known in the Southern California boxing scene as the dude who can get you rounds and a spar, and he does a great job doing it.
He's the guy you have to be ready for. Ochoa, once again, you can't judge him by his record. You want to look at the number of rounds he's gone. He's gone 85 total pro rounds, almost twice as many rounds as Ivan Delgado has gone. And
right.
I think that can be a factor in this fight,
particularly
100%. Once the fight heats up.
Yeah, if you haven't gone that many rounds into any of your fights, or you know, you haven't fought that many longer fights, and somebody comes in with that many rounds under their belts, at a certain point the experience kicks in, you know, and those later rounds is when it kind of shows up.
Delgado has gone the distance a number of times, but his overall quality of opposition, not as tough as the gatekeeper, the guy who's often brought in as an opponent.
Is that Thunderstruck he's walking into? It is, right?
I don't know, but I like his shoes. Okay. He's got some flashy shoes on, too.
A little AC/DC Thunderstruck for Ochoa. Could that be some foreshadowing from him? You've seen him here at Velasco Theater, ladies and gentlemen. And there he is, repping South Central on his jacket. Boxing Lifestyles taking care of him with the gear. Mexican-American fighter, father of two. Actually, he has father three. That's right, he just had a baby recently. He has Alina, Destiny, and Aiden.
He knows what he's fighting for.
Yep. Aiden is actually, he tattooed it on his right fist.
Yeah.
Because Aiden, as he said, is the one helping him throw those punches when he's in the ring. He has a special moment, special tattoo for him, the baby Aiden.
He's somebody who's very serious. He's somebody who screwed up. Somebody who, when he could have been making his name as a local amateur, he was running with the wrong crowd.
Right.
And at a time where he could have been finishing up his amateur career and making his name as a young pro, he was incarcerated. So he's had to make up for lost time, and he's very thankful for the opportunity that he has to be fighting as part of the series.
Próxima pelea está pactada por Ochoa Santos en el peso ligero. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, 8 rounds of boxing. This is in the lightweight division. Otra vez los tres jueces. Once again, your three judges, Raúl Caín, Jerry Cantu, and Zach Young. Y el encargado de ring, your referee in charge of the action, Hall of Famer Dr. Lou Moran. Presentado primero la esquina azul, con los pantaloncillos azul y verde limón, y un peso de 130 libras y tres cuartos. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing blue trunks with lime green, he weighed officially 130 and 3/4 pounds. Un veterano de 20 peleas de Santana, California, presentando Alejandro Ochoa. Y su frente en la esquina roja, con los pantaloncillos multicolores y un peso de 132 libras. His opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wears multicolored trunks tonight. He weighed officially 132 pounds. Con un récord perfecto de 9 victorias, 0 derrotas, 1 empate y 2 ganadas por nocaut. He stands perfect in the ring tonight. 9 victories, no defeats. 1 draw with 2 wins coming by way of knockout. Presentando de Ciudad de Los Ángeles, California, el invicto, Iván Stricker Delgado.
Thank you, bro. Gentlemen, I give you a stretch and dressing. You just have a good, clean fight. Return your opponent and wait the bell. Good luck.
Dr. Lou Moret, the third man in the ring. Let's look at the tail of the tape, Dougie.
And they match up almost equally. Delgado is 1 year younger. Their height and their reach is equal.
26-year-old Delgado, Alejandro Ochoa. Alex, 27 years old. He comes from a fighting family. And we are underway in our co-feature at the Belasco Theater. Bethel Duran, Doug Fisher, Holly Lawson. It's scheduled for 8 rounds in the lightweight division. 9-0 is Ivan Delgado. He's in the black and gray trunks. And the blue with lime is Alex Ochoa. Most recent fight for Delgado, he's went the distance with Jesus Sandoval in March here at the Belasco. Or Ochoa, mentioned earlier, was stopped in the second by Chipa Gonzalez. An impressive win for Gonzalez. Delgado, good amateur background, over 70 amateur fights. Then as a teenager, ran it with the wrong crowd, got himself incarcerated. And he felt that when he came out, it was a second chance. The names of Jojo Diaz, Julian Ramirez, Joel Gonzalez, fighters that he had gone up against in the amateurs, he sees them going to the next level. He said he knows he has to play catch up with them. He can't afford to make mistakes. He stays away from that former life. Now he's a family man, 3 kids. Goes run, takes the kids to school, goes back to work out. Now living in Montebello.
Keeping his composure well under Ochoa's early aggression. And that's what you want to do. That's something that Rivers Jr. did not do. He was a little bit surprised by the early aggression from Ochoa and tried to return fire in kind. And that's when he got caught with a left hook near the end of the first round.
A little bit of a knot underneath the right eye of Delgado here in the first round. Overhand right from Delgado. He's got the black. And Ochoa, he's 27 years old, 7-11-2, only 1 KO on his ledger. But he's that fighter that's just going to mix it up with you when he gets caught with the left. Did he go down?
He was hurt, though. No, he did not go down.
Oh, yes, he is.
Perhaps one of his gloves touched canvas.
The glove touched the canvas, according to Dr. Lou Moret. It was close. It happened really fast.
I didn't see it. I definitely saw his right leg buckle, though.
But he did get caught with the left hook from Delgado.
And so right now, he's dealing with demons from his previous fight. He's kind of worried about his own chin and his own punch resistance, since the last time he got hurt, he was not able to recover.
Another left from Delgado. Orocha, this is what he does, Holly. He comes out, he scraps with you. If you fall into his trap, you can be in for a long night. Going to be up to Delgado, maintain his composure.
He's doing a really good job of that so far. Maintaining his distance, definitely staying calm. You get sucked into somebody else's kind of their fight and their energy, that's going to drain you.
Well, especially when you come in as the opponent, right?
Yeah, 100%. You want to fight your fight. You want to establish.
Uppercut from Delgado, 10 seconds ago in the opening round. Ooh. Rocha's glove did touch the mat, so it will be ruled as a 10-8 round for Ivan Delgado. We're scheduled for 8. A little bit more behind each fighter, or crack staff has put together a sweet graphic with bios on both of the fighters.
Born in Michoacan, he's won 4 of his last 6 bouts, and we should point out that those 4 bouts were against unbeaten fighters.
Pretty impressive.
And Michoacan, Mexico, in the southern part of the state.
He's definitely a game fighter. He's there to fight. He's not here to be run over. He's not here to provide a little bit of opposition.
That's why
he's
a gatekeeper and not a journeyman.
Right.
And
how do you figure out the difference, Doug? Well, it's a fine line, isn't it?
Yeah, a journeyman can go in there and put up a fight, but they usually lose. They almost always lose. A gatekeeper is going to spring the upset.
Gotcha.
Often enough to earn that title.
It's something in the demeanor. So the gatekeeper is there to fight, and they might win.
Right.
And the journeyman is there to provide rounds,
exactly.
And they kind of act like it. There's something in their disposition and
like
their posture.
A live dog,
right? Well, the journeyman has that mentality that I'm not here to win.
Right. I'm here
to give you some resistance.
Fight.
Right.
Yeah.
Gatekeeper comes in saying, you know what? I think I can
win
this. And I'm going to try.
The gatekeeper, I'm not a gatekeeper.
There you go. I can be something better than that. I can be a contender.
I'm better than my record. How many times have we heard that in fighter meetings?
Always.
Like, no, I've never lost.
I got a good reason for every loss.
Like, we can't find footage of that fight. Oh, no, I won. The judges, it was his backyard, you know.
Right.
Second round, Bethan Rand, Doug Fisher, and Holly Lawson enjoying the Belasco Theater, LA Fight Club, sold out again. Body work from Ochoa. This is his style, Holly.
Just kind of wild. Lots of flurries of fast punches. Doesn't seem to be a lot behind them, though.
Both guys have a pretty good foundation, but yeah, Ochoa does have sort of an awkwardness
Absolutely.
To his delivery.
Crossing his feet when he, you know, steps laterally sometimes. But he comes forward quickly, and that can be disorienting, you know? You can't get back quick enough. All of a sudden, he's on top of you.
And that's where he makes up for his lack of power. That's why he was
right.
able to score knockdowns against unbeaten prospects, is that he catches him by surprise.
It just takes that one punch and kept somebody just going back with their hands down.
Ochoa is going to the body, but he keeps getting nailed by that left hook from Delgado.
Yeah, he's eating a couple, and he's landing one. But he's eating two or three at a time.
Yeah, he's got to bring that right hand up. Come up with a way to evade that left, because Delgado's looking for it now.
And he's swinging with bad intentions. That left hook is coming pretty fast.
Who is, Delgado?
Yes, absolutely.
That's something that Roberto Diaz, the matchmaker for Golden Boy, said, that Delgado has an ability to let his hands go, but he hasn't done it the last four fights that we've seen him do. That's something that they talked about. They wanted him to do that in this fight, let the hands go, because he was just being tentative at times.
He is hesitating a little bit here.
He was stuck in cruise control in his last fight, and that was the one point of criticism that I had, is that it seemed like if he wanted to, he could have stepped up a gear and taken over the fight and maybe earned a stoppage, but he sort of cruised to a points win.
He just pulled a punch. He stepped backwards, and he could have stepped forward with a punch, and he pulled it. Maybe the same thing.
The first eight-round fight for Ivan Delgado. The other ones have been six. Four straight wins of decision within six rounds. Last time he got a stoppage was in May of last year when he stopped Benjamin Vincent in the third. You see, Ochoa's not going anywhere.
No. Nope.
This is a competitive round.
This is Ochoa style. Make it ugly, make it rugged, and try to steal some rounds. And he's trained by Clemente Medina. Okay.
Yeah, and Medina is somebody who's trained many former world champions, including Daniel Ponce de Leon and Abner Mares and Alfredo Angulo.
A representative came to my school talking about the different programs and information security was one. Family, friends, but the best part about graduation day was when I got to announce to my family that I had gotten the job. For some, school is a backup plan, but for me, it was the only plan. And I ended up choosing ITT Tech over other four-year institutions.
Scholarships and financial aid are available for students who qualify. Call 800-227-2162. That's 800-227-2162.
Ring TV Live is brought to you by ITT Technical Institute. ITT Tech for the future. Call today, 800-227-2162. Find out more info. Schedule that free tour, 800-227-2162. Third round of action underway. And Alex Ochoa and the blue and neon is an interesting character. Doug, you've taught me this over the years in boxing. Everybody has a story and their characters. Well, this dude, if you go on his Instagram, he doesn't have his name on there. He calls himself Chihuen, using the Mayan name. He's from Puropencha descent. That's the area of Michoacan where he's from. So he's really into his Aztec and Mayan roots. He says he's conscious, revolutionary, teacher, activist, knowledge, and wisdom. And then at the bottom, pro boxer.
That's last, huh? Yeah, he's got that look.
Yeah.
Like his hair and everything.
He's definitely a warrior.
Yeah, you look at his face, he does. Right. He has the look of an ancient warrior or like an activist.
Well, Doug, you say in Spanish, guerrero.
He's showing it right now.
I mean,
in this
he's
third
really
round.
Letting his hands go.
Yeah, that body attack is
yeah.
nice.
Oh,
there you see that.
Good
go
counter
back.
With Delgado.
Holly, you were saying that left hook from Delgado, he's throwing it viciously, and he landed that one there, snapping back the head of the activist Ochoa.
I have to wonder why Delgado's not going to Ochoa's body a little bit more, kind of slow him down a little bit.
Especially considering he was stopped in his last fight.
Right. And with somebody who, you know, moves that much and they're an active puncher, you want to slow him down a little bit, get him back to your pace so you can fight your fight.
that one of the advantages of having an extensive amateur career is it just conditions fighters to let their hands go all the time. And Delgado doesn't have it. He's got more of a style that you get, that you see in sparring sessions.
Right.
Like really good sparring right. sessions where you're taking your time a little bit more and it's not so much about activity. But although he defends well, he blocks well, he has a nice high guard there, he can be outworked.
Yeah.
And I would say he's being outworked right now by Ochoa.
And the thing is, if you're going to take your time, you have to make sure the punches thrown are really doing some damage.
Ochoa,
so when you throw those punches, they have to do something.
Ochoa has a chin. He can take those punches. He's been in some battles over the years. Ali makes a great point. Why is he not going to the body? You've seen it. He can wear that punch to the chin. Delgado sparred in the past with Leo Santa Cruz. Works out at the same gym as Leo. With Leo's father out there. So he gets good work. Good movement by Delgado.
He really does kind of hesitate a little bit, though. He'll get back to the center of the ring, and then he won't throw when he has the opportunity to throw.
Yeah, right now, with this round, the story of round three for me is Delgado is content to block punches.
Yep.
He's not throwing enough, and I think Ochoa is winning this round because he's outworked him. And I like the body. The body punches are landing for Ochoa.
Well, yes. Deja vu against Kevin Rivers. I swear I heard that last year.
Ooh.
Final seconds of the third. It's scheduled for 8. Good action in the third round, Holly.
Definitely. Ochoa throwing a lot of punches, landing some body shots there to Delgado.
There was a right followed by a left, and both of them were scoring punches from Ochoa, but he leaves himself open for those
left hook
counters.
Absolutely.
Fourth round, it's scheduled for 8. Xihui, as he calls himself in the blue. Maybe see a matchup meeting breaking out. He's taking on Ivan Delgado. A good battle here at the Belasco Theater. And Dougie, after 3, how do you have it?
I have it 2-1, or 29-27 for Delgado because of the knockdown scored in round 1. First 2 rounds went to Delgado. Third round went to Ochoa. I thought he outworked Delgado.
Holly?
I have it the same, actually. I think Ochoa took the third round. He was just far more active and a little more accurate.
Was eavesdropping in the corner of Ochoa with Clemente in the corner. They're telling him, breathe. You need to breathe in that corner.
That's great advice.
Very important.
Sometimes just keep it simple. Keep it to the basics. If your fighter doesn't look like he's getting enough oxygen, remind him. Just settle him down.
Holly, in the second you said he should go to the body, that being Delgado, hasn't done it. Is landing some big shots upstairs, but Ochoa keeps coming.
Yeah, he keeps coming. And the thing is, Delgado's slipping some of Ochoa's punches, so he's already in a position to throw to the body, and he's just not letting go.
Ooh,
good nice
action.
Uppercut.
And that one tagged him. That one hurt. And Ochoa's still on his feet.
Wow.
Las Vegas are getting loose.
But Ochoa's legs were stiffened than those punches, and that looked like it was a right hand from Delgado that first did the damage.
Yes.
Striker Delgado, a big crowd on his side, wearing his shirt. Very patient here.
Oh, really right nice right hand.
Good timing, good accuracy from Delgado. But Holly, one thing I think is missing from Delgado's game right now, and that's a jab.
100%.
Where is it?
It's non-existent. He's waiting for the other person to come with the jab and then trying to counter, but his counters are, you know, sometimes a little bit slow or not there at all. When he's throwing, he's doing great, though. So he really does just need to throw more punches. There was a jab there.
Yeah.
Landed. So there you go.
Maybe he hurt.
You're right.
Why does he need to throw that jab right now, Doug?
I think that's his style. He's never had a busy jab. I've never seen him really work that jab.
No, but why do you want him to throw it?
because it ups his activity. It keeps him from being outworked from Ochoa. It gives Ochoa something to think about so he just doesn't come in and out with impunity. And I also think, you know, the jab is an underrated punch in terms of doing damage. It makes your opponent dizzy. If you can land a jab consistently, a stiff jab, round after round, the jab alone will make your opponent woozy and soften them up for the power punches. And, of course, it helps set up the power punches.
10 seconds to go in the fourth round. Good action between Ivan Delgado and Alex Ochoa on Ring TV Live from Los Angeles.
Ochoa missing with an overhand right, getting clipped with a right uppercut, and caught with some follow-up hooks. But he struggled to stay on his feet, and he did.
Definitely a warrior there. Definitely living up to his multi-hyphenate Instagram bio.
And there was a nice right cross landed by Delgado in that second highlight.
Back at the Belasco Theater, Bethel Duran, Doug Fisher, and Holly Lawson. Keep the tweets coming using the hashtag RingTVLive. Fifth round, it's scheduled for 8. Delgado in the black and silver. Against Alex Ochoa in the blue and neon.
That was the best round from Delgado we saw round 4. He let his hands go a little bit more.
Another good left hook. Roberto Diaz said one of the things that he doesn't like about Ivan Delgado, and it was just constructive criticism, he said that he makes things hard for himself. He works harder than he should in a fight.
I would agree with that statement.
What makes you see that?
He has the tools, but he's not doing the small things like the jab. Dougie was saying he's clear that if you throw the jab, you're going to keep somebody off you. You're definitely going to think about it more, and it's going to set up those other power punches. So he's just waiting for one big punch. He's a little more active. It would kind of feed into other things for him, I think.
I'm enjoying this fight. It's awkward at points, and we're all three of us are in agreement that Delgado needs to have a higher punch output, but I see a lot of craft from both fighters.
Yeah, 100%.
Ochoa's work rate has slowed down.
Might not be breathing enough.
Ochoa's brother, actually, Francisco Ochoa, we've seen him a couple times on Ring TV Live. Younger brother.
He's squared up right in front of Delgado.
Starting to look a little bit tired, isn't he?
Yeah, Delgado didn't make him pay for that, though.
Well, you see the scorecards. Doug has it.
I have a 39-36, so I have 3-1 for Delgado. Delgado gets an extra point for the knockdown score, the technical knockdown score in the opening round.
And Holly's card.
I have it scored the same, 39-36.
Great minds think alike.
3-1 for Delgado, clearly.
But Ochoa's still in this fight.
27-year-old Ochoa, Santa Ana, California. Coming in this fight, had 85 pro rounds experience on his side.
Definitely slowing down, though. Breathing pretty heavy.
He's a bit of a boxing nomad in Southern California. Ooh. Doesn't have a main gym.
Good left hook again.
He was momentarily rocked by that left hook.
He's been momentarily rocked by a lot of left hooks.
Yeah, it's happened 3 or 4 times so far in this fight.
But he recovers really well, though.
Well, you know what? Delgado is allowing him the time. And
absolutely. Absolutely.
Good point. Doesn't jump on it after he stuns him. Final seconds of the fifth round. Entertaining fight between Delgado and Ochoa, the co-feature. And the main event is Shabransky.
Fight. Amigo, ya lo tienes, güey, ¿eh? Ya nada más hay que meterle el último pinche estocazo, güey. El último golpe final. El upper, mete gancho y vuelve a meter el upper. Ahí se va a quedar, güey. Bien. Órale, pues.
No me la des quebrada. Puerto Rico. Antonio
Gutierrez, representando a México. Chale, chale. Más agüita.
OCHOA going to work with Delgado's back against the ropes, working both sides of Delgado. We noted that OCHOA was looking kind of tired, but he's still giving that effort. And I may have even scored that round for OCHOA, but he got caught with that left hook that momentarily wobbled him. And that's why I scored it for Delgado.
Our next broadcast will be November. I'm getting ahead of myself.
He's trying to go to Mardi Gras in Canada.
You know, Mardi Gras to Whistler, baby. September 2nd, we'll be here at the Belasco Theater. Tony Martinez from TJ is the main event. Also, Christian Chimpo Gonzalez, the co-feature. Does that mean we can send some birthday shout-outs to Sal Carrillo? Turns 21 again and again at a Paramount or Long Beach or Downey, wherever you want to be from, Sal. Happy birthday to you. That's all from your friend Tony Contreras in Vista. It all like Art LeBeau here, giving all your shout outs here in the sixth round. Ivan Delgado in the black and silver. Ochoa's corner was telling him, you have to be first, you're running out of time.
They're keeping it real with their fighter.
I feel like he's been first the whole night, though. He hasn't necessarily leaned in his favor, but he's definitely been first. He's been the aggressor the whole time, he's coming forward.
And you like his effort.
I do. I mean, as a fighter, you got to respect that, you know?
You're not getting points forever.
Definitely not. But I respect it.
Choa had that tight bun going early in the fight. He hit by a couple lefts, shakes the hair loose.
Again, ooh, really good left hook.
You like that left hook?
I love that left hook. He needs to catch him every time he throws it. He just needs to let it go more and maybe set it up with the right hand.
Right.
Delgado,
lead with something, throw a jab,
throw a left hook.
Come back with the cross. You know, if you land the lead left hook, come back with the cross. Yeah.
You know, Delgado, the thing where he's not throwing that much, it's a little bit of a sparring partner mentality, right? Where you throw and then you back off and you give the guy a second to catch his breath. You step back a little bit, you take your time. Like, this isn't what you do in a fight. You step your game up because you're not sparring. You're here to take this guy out. That's his experience.
That's how he learned, was more from sparring and than sometimes from those amateur bouts. He had over 70 amateur bouts, but that was all as a kid.
Right.
That was all 8, 9, 10, 11. You know, it was like kid stuff. But and also, it gave him a foundation, but his style is forged in the sparring.
Right, and he has a good style. He has good technical abilities. He really, you know, he catches the punches. He has good high guard. He has a good jab when he throws it. But there's something, that hesitation sometimes is something you see in people who are, this is a bit of a sparring partner mentality.
And also 4 years incarcerated. He had no training, couldn't really get anything to work. So that's 4 years lost.
True.
I know Bernard would tell you it's good, healthy living. But regardless, though, you're losing those years. Bernard will tell you. He loves talking to Dougie. Bernard Hopkins, legend.
I love talking to Bernard.
Oh, we love him and Malik.
Uncle B. Uncle B is my favorite.
Last of the great fighters.
Another good round for Delgado. Estrellita is working the mitts. Shabransky is loosening up. Vyacheslav Slava Shabransky, Ukraine. Now living in Los Angeles. Getting ready. Edgar Jasso, second trainer, getting him loose. That's our main event coming up. Shabransky, undefeated fighter, 16-0, 13 KOs on his record. Light heavyweight. There was some talk of maybe Andre Ward for him, but he actually took a fighter named Alexander Brand, who trains at the same gym as Shabransky.
Trained by the same trainer.
Trained by the same trainer. So Slava would come in and say the guy that he wanted to fight, nope, here's the guy, Slava. You have to come to the side. Get ready. Is he a good packed crowd? Chimpa. Chimpa's dad. Father of Corita Gonzalez, former world champion. Seventh round of action. Bethel Duran, Doug Fisher, Holly Lawson underway. In our co-feature, Joe Martinez, your ring announcer tonight. Look at that drive from the Lake Elsinore Storm. Take care of everybody. Got Western Michigan and Dorsey High running this timekeeper tonight. Nobody worried about the Olympics, Doug. I know you love your track on Sundays, but right now, it's nobody's running in that ring. Good old-fashioned scrap.
Yeah, it is. There's footwork, but there's no running.
You run on Sundays, huh? Your periscopes with Coach Schwartz?
I've seen the periscopes.
Yes.
Ooh. Oh, really good left hook there.
Ivan Delgado runs Mount Baldy. It's that elevation training, 2,000 feet of elevation in a 3-mile run. You can see the conditioning factor really good for him right now.
Oh, that was a nice jab to the body.
Jab to the body.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, when last time we said that? Anything to the body.
That was the first time for Delgado in this particular fight.
Not that we're picking on him, but it's the same thing that Yuka, his trainer, is going to come back and tell him. Like, we have to do this, especially when you get past a gatekeeper and you want to take that next level.
He has the tools. It's just an issue of him putting them together and making them work for him.
Like, is it more just amount of ring experience that it comes through for him to get those tools?
No, he has the tools. Like, they're there. He has a good jab when he uses it. He has a great left hook. The right hand seems pretty good when he throws it, too. It's just that he's not letting it go. And
yeah,
that
it's a mental,
thing.
Yeah,
and
it's mental.
The mental thing is sometimes you can
And that tackle. And down goes Ochoa. And it is over.
That's it.
Stoppage. Dr. Lou Moret jumps in it. He's seen a lot of guys go down in his career. And Ochoa, the pride that he has, the warrior attitude, he gets back to his feet. But, Doug, he was out as soon as he was dropped. 142 in the seventh for Ivan Delgado, his third KO of his career.
We had some criticism for Delgado, but all's well that ends well. And I was about to say, it's not just about getting the W against the gatekeeper. You want to make a statement. Well, this is how you do it. He stuns him with the left, follows up with the left and the right,
and
follows up with
the
another
body.
Left.
Yeah.
Ollie, you were saying it all night. You love that left hook. You saw two of them right there.
Absolutely.
In the fight.
Look at that.
Boom. That first left hook took the legs.
And he hit him on the chin with that all night.
The follow-up left was right on the button, right to the chin. And
really,
I'm sure,
really good performance there. Really
absolutely.
Nice performance.
Great follow-up, great finish.
Yes.
But I'm sure Dr. Lou Moret saw the follow-up left hook, boom, right there on his way down. And decided, you know what, that's too much to overcome. Boom, that left hook, lead left. Discombobulates Ochoa. Ochoa is reeling. Delgado closes the distance, and a follow-up, shorter hook, right on the button.
Yeah, you don't ever want to put anyone's brain at risk.
It was already
especially when they have a big heart, and they're just going to keep coming. Like, you really got to respect someone stepping in. I love Lou Moret. He's actually my favorite.
Dr. Lou jumped in there. Stopped it immediately, and he's in there. He saw probably the eyes of Ochoa go back.
Right.
Ivan Delgado, his third KO. After Roberto Diaz, the matchmaker, said he expected tonight because he wanted to see this kid let his hands go, and now, Holly, you were mentioning it, let his hands go, and here's what happens.
Well, we talked about it being a mental thing, letting the hands go, and I think maybe scarring a knockout like that is encouragement.
Yeah, 100%. I think sometimes you need to know that when you do let your hands go, you're going to have the effect that you want to have.
You're going to get results.
And seeing the results, you know, can encourage that.
Delgado comes over, shakes the hand of Clemente Medina. These two fighters know each other. Because of that Southern California boxing scene, Doug, they go to different gyms. They go to spar. They see people all over the time. So a lot of respect and mutual admiration for them. This wasn't any kind of a trash-talking matchup. It was like, no, we know we got to get past a guy like Ochoa. We've seen better days.
These guys are very mature for being 26 and 27 years old for different reasons.
Striker Delgado, father of three. Aiden on his tattooed on his right hand. Aiden.
Definitely proud of him tonight.
Yes, he is. Destiny and Aaliyah, all his daughters right there.
And I see Delgado is wearing a medallion from the WBC, and I don't know what this means, if that means this win got him a ranking in the WBC. You know, WBC rankings, they have rankings all the way to, like, number 30.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no, definitely he's not top 10, top 15.
My eyebrow raised.
He's on his way. Yeah, I saw you raise your eyebrow. But, yeah, the WBC will rank the top 30 fighters in a particular division, unlike the other sanctioning organizations, which go to 10 or 15.
Right.
So maybe he's in that top 30. And
that'd be a nice
look
for him.
If so, congratulations. If not, hey, that's a cool-looking medallion.
Ain't nothing wrong with wearing a medallion, especially if it's gold, baby.
Yeah, look at it. Yeah.
Looks huge. Take that. And they put it on immediately.
Yeah.
When we catch up with it, we'll see what that means. Ivan Delgado now 10-0 with three KOs, a seventh round stoppage for the fighter born in South Central Los Angeles. Here's Joe.
42 segundos, el séptimo asalto de referee para la pelea para el ganador por nocaut se mantiene invicto. The end comes officially 1 minute, 42 seconds, round number 7. We have your winner by KO victory. He is still undefeated, Ivan Striker.
Six-year-old Ivan Delgado, 10-0. You see with his trainer Yuka. In an interview by Spanish TV. We'll be back with more from the Belasco Theater. You're watching Ring TV Live.
Los cinturones aquí se hacen a un lado. Hay que pelear por honor y por gloria nada más.
Liam's a talent, he'll fight anyone. And we're gonna make a big fight for him in the autumn. I think he's the biggest name in that division, and I will make sure it happens. And I believe by the end of the year, he will be the best.
Dallas, Texas. Cowboy Stadium. Canelo, Smith, Mexico, England. That's the main event. More than half of the tickets have already been sold. Go to Golden Boy Promotions, buy your tickets. I know the flights are cheap right now, Will. We can get on there. We can get on those cheap tickets right now. It's a one way. The Rams play the next day. You know, we can get that first 6 a.m. flight coming back home. Will Wright, our director and vice president for Golden Boy Promotions, Bethel Duran, Doug Fisher, Holly Lawson, and we have a great staff working in the dungeon of the Belasco Theater, putting it together. Appreciate you guys with the graphics and the Chiron and the audio. Everybody doing a good job tonight, as always. My executive vice president David Tatro, Scott Tatro here, Ted, the stage manager tonight. Emilio Sanchez, undefeated fighter from San Fernando, is in attendance. Dr. Lou Moret also working the ring tonight as we're waiting for Ivan Delgado to make his way over with that Canelo card. Yeah, Jojo Diaz, Diego De Loya.
Hey, the
Gabe
month of
Rosado.
September, that's a terrific, terrific month for boxing, and people shouldn't sleep on Liam Smith, but never mind Smith right now. We got the striker Delgado with us.
Breathe, baby, breathe.
Yeah, congratulations, Ivan.
I know you're up there taking a lot of pictures, shaking hands and everything, but first thing, though, what's this medallion? What is this? What did they give?
This was given to my trainer, rest in peace, who passed away last year.
I see.
And ever since, I carry it, you know, I carry it wherever I go in each corner, in each fight. I walk out with it, it's like, he's still with me in the corner.
That was Yuka.
With you in spirit, it's good luck.
Yeah.
So Yuka, who passed away a year ago, that was given to him, and you wear that.
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool. We were trying to figure out what exactly that was. Yeah. Show it to the crowd again. Right there, the camera. Hey.
The little one.
That's in memory of Yuka, one of the legendary trainers in Southern California. Yeah. But now you tonight, though. It's your second KO. Dude, where'd that power come in from last round?
You know, that's something that I've always had a power, you know? I got power, and it was just a matter of sitting down more in our punches, you know, and being more accurate and not throwing just to throw, you know? And I knocked out with the left hook before, too. And like I said, I know I got power in both hands. It was just a matter of sitting down on our punches and not just throwing wild or without being on our legs.
You were throwing that left hook with efficiency whenever you wanted it. Yeah. How come we haven't seen that in other fights?
Well, the reason was in other fights, I was trying to move around more, a little counterpuncher, more defensive, and that's what it was, you know. But now it's time to step it up and be more accurate, and basically, whenever we hit, we make sure to hurt him.
The accuracy was there. The power was there. You were really the ring general, even though Ochoa really brought it tonight. A lot of activity. The one criticism that we have, and you'll see it when you watch this fight again, we thought you needed a jab, and we thought that you needed to move your hands a little bit more. At what point in the fight did it kind of click to put those shots together? Because as soon as you did, you didn't just hurt him, you put him away, as we're gonna see some highlights here.
Yeah, what do you see right here, Ivan?
Right there, I was going to the body, and they told me to go downstairs, you know? And since I went downstairs, you know, coming back upstairs, I knew I was landing the hook, and they were telling me to throw the upper also, you know? But I see him throw himself at me, and I was just trying to stay a little calm and kind of get him with the hook because I knew he sometimes expected that upper, and I didn't feel comfortable throwing that upper when he came in, so that's the reason I threw the hook.
He's a pressure fighter. You know him very well. I mean, a lot of people know Ochoa. Here's how the fight finished. That's got to feel good.
Yeah, that does feel good, you know, coming back with a knockout, you know, and like I said, I know I've always had the power. It's just a matter of putting our punches together. And the reason I wasn't throwing that jab as much is because I felt he was going to come into me, you know. I didn't want to come into him too much. Right. I was waiting a little bit more calm for him to throw himself at me and just get him with a good shot.
10-0, Ivan Stryker Delgado gets his third KO. There's that camera. Send that shout out to your kids, man.
You know, I just want to send a shout out to all my kids, you know, well, my two daughters, you know, and my son, you know. I do everything for them, and especially my family and everybody in South Central, you know.
Hasta español, échale si quieres.
You know, saludos a todos mi gente, mi familia. Ahí está, también está en Los Ángeles, Sur Central de México. And also shout out to all my sponsors, you know, El Centenario, Winners Collision, Tacos Don Eve, and Boxing Lifestyle, and of course my team, MT Sports, and Golden World for the opportunity. And you know, it feels good, you know, being a co-main event and finishing the fight like this.
Roberto Diaz said, if you came out impressive, there could be another fight for you later on this year. Ivan Stryker Delgado, our co-feature. So that's four fights, four knockouts. Our main event coming up, Slava Shabransky against Oscar Riojas. And Shabransky sat down with our Golden Boy cameras.